Andrew with Evermore Studio here with a quick build video for my Oculus Quest wall mount. If you want to make your own, the files will be up at the Evermore Studio site. I will put a link in the description below. I recently got an Oculus Quest VR headset to help me face down another several months inside for the long Phoenix summer. Leaving it sitting on the floor just didn't seem right, so I decided to hang it on the wall. I have some neat quarter-inch glass green acrylic, and I thought I would try heat bending it into a workable shape. Note that I am not an acrylic working expert. There may be better ways of doing some of this, but what I did worked out great. The headset itself probably just needed a sturdy hook. However, I wanted to hang the controllers some way other than the straps, especially since I'm considering switching to a different strap design. After a few measurements, I came up with an initial controller hook and cut a quick cardboard prototype for testing. Apart from the hooks, the shape of the overall design is fairly arbitrary. I wanted to make sure there was enough surface area to keep it on the wall despite any rotational forces from hanging and removing the headset. It seemed like a good idea to keep the heat pretty localized to avoid warping the base that would go against the wall or creating any odd irregularities. So I cut forms from MDF draft board to protect adjacent areas from getting as hot and to limit the bending to the desired planes. I used this small heat gun instead of my full-size one to help keep the heat targeted. It took a bit to get it hot enough to bend, about 4 minutes for each spot. After getting the acrylic hot enough to bend, I held each bend in the desired position for a couple of minutes while it cooled enough to hold the new shape. After using a chopstick to hold the first upturn on the first controller hook, I noticed that it had created a round indent on the end. This seemed workable as an artistic accent, so I used the same approach to make the remaining prongs match. The second controller hook worked the same way. Thank you. then the central hook for the headset. Using a flat piece of material to hold it in position distributed the pressure enough to prevent marring the acrylic. I originally planned to cut holes for drywall screws with engraved countersink depressions for the heads. Instead, I ended up using some command strip picture mounts. Each of the two strips is rated to hold 16 pounds or a bit over 7 kilograms. That's many times the weight of the Quest with its controllers and a battery pack. These don't leave holes in the wall or the acrylic and can be removed from both with minimal effort if I end up wanting to move the wall mount or do something different. I prepped the wall with removable sticky notes to help get it up straight. I checked it with a level afterwards and it's spot on. I have the files to make your own Quest wall mount available for free on the Evermore Studios site. There will be a link in the description below. I know not everyone has a laser cutter, but many communities have makerspaces where you can get access to tools like laser cutters and assistance learning to use them for free or for a small fee or donation. Support your local communities, learn new skills, and make new friends. If you found this helpful or entertaining and would like me to share more projects like this, please like and subscribe. Your comments are welcome here or on the Evermore Studio site. Thanks for watching.